Shit too. How are you doing this today? It's afternoon for you.
It's great. Well, it could be better, but next week is going to be a really good week. So, you know, and then I'll be having less interviews. So I'll enjoy the sunshine outside. Now that's not good weather. It's also pretty good to be inside. So
that's good. It's kind of gray out here where I am too right now. It's colder for this time of year.
So. Yeah, for us as well.
Really? Okay, so it's just a little bit more to add to 2020 that we're all dealing with.
Exactly.
Yeah, great. Exactly. So right now, with Sharon, with Within Temptation right now, just for everyone who's watching, we have so much going on right now in 2020. You have a busy year, like, planned up until coronavirus hit everyone and now no one has plans. However, you have been busy though. Last week you came out with Entertain You with your band. Can you tell us a bit more about just how the creation of that came about, like where the process came from and how you got together to do this, and if you were isolated or you were able to meet up, things like that?
Well, we actually wrote it just before the coronavirus hit us. Whoops.
You're good.
the thing was, we were supposed to go on tour and we felt like, okay, we haven't had last year already an extensive tour. So we felt like we have to give our fans something new to listen to enjoy. And, but then of course the tour got, postponed and right. The festivals were postponed. And we felt like, okay, well, what are we going to do now with the release of this new single? Mm-hmm. And we felt like, okay, maybe just release it because there's nothing else people can look forward to. So if we can contribute in a small way, in our own way, with our own music, then for our fans anyway, it will be maybe something to look forward to. So that's why we released it now. But we just before everything closed down, we, you know, just did the video recordings and stuff like that. Still had it to edit it, which is happening now.
Awesome.
But yeah. So really the last week we were just doing last things, and then all of a sudden everything was closed down. We saw it coming a little bit, of course, but
so you guys stayed really busy, like up until that very minute when you realized we have to go inside. That's awesome though that you guys are still doing that. The video's coming soon then, hopefully, if it's already done filming.
Absolutely. Yeah, we can't film anything now. It's too difficult. But it's more like everything was filmed before and now we have to edit everything. And so it's almost finished.
Okay, awesome. So just to more ask about like what's going on in 2020. The last time I saw Within Temptation was in New York last year with the Resist tour and things like that with In Flames. And it was so great to see that. That was such a great concert experience. So much has changed. That venue, PlayStation Theater, not around anymore. There's so many.
Really?
Yeah.
Out of course. Yeah.
Yeah. Just so many things like that are happening now. And now no concerts are happening. No festivals are happening. No. We're hopeful that we're going to see Within Temptation on the road later this year in Europe and things like that with a big tour. I'll ask about that later. But what do you see the biggest difference for you going forward as a live performer? How do you think the biggest differences are going to hit you performing at concerts and things like that? Because, like, do you think it'll be able to get back to the same what it was? Or do you think there'll be permanent differences now?
I hope so. I think before, if there is not going to be a vaccine before we're going to start again, they will have to make changes to the venues, how many people that can be, and how you are able to watch these shows, of course. So that's what I suspect. But I hope the vaccine will be sooner, or any kind of medicine. Mm-hmm. But until that time, I don't think it will go back to normal, to be honest, if I'm really realistic.
I agree.
It's already so difficult to stay 1.5 meters in normal, you know, even going to the supermarket, I go crazy. It's like people can't keep distance from 1.5 meters.
Exactly. So many people, like people in the States now are just giving up on the masks idea too. No one's even trying to do that anymore.
And not really. Here they're still trying, but it's like everybody's frustrating when it doesn't work. So everybody gets upset about it. So it's like, okay.
it's a team effort and not everyone on the team's playing, you know, and not everyone is. I also made the joke, I was laughing about this before, if like bands got really smart about it, like Within Temptation designed masks for their merch, like a Within Temptation mask, that's going to be a new fashion statement, everyone having their own mask.
Yeah, we are actually producing them now, actually.
Oh, there you go. See, I knew I had a good idea. Someone beat me to it. That's totally fine. So there's cool things to happen, though. I know the big tour later this year for September, October in Europe with Evanescence, that's been so hyped up. Do you think, and we're being optimistic, hopefully everything still happens. Hopefully everything by then will be back to normal enough to where this tour can happen. So there's so many cool things about that tour, though. What are you most excited about hitting the road with Evanescence for? And I've seen you've done interviews with Amy Lee and things like that also. What are some of the biggest things that you're looking forward to in 2020 on that tour with Evanescence?
Well, I just hope that's especially of course for the fans, because I think the our two bands together is probably I can imagine as a fan that you will like to see both of them, and it's a very rare thing to happen. And I know what our plans are as for a show, and I know what their plans are, and you're in for a hell of a surprise. So I think
Okay.
can't give
Surprises,
anything away
surprises are
yet.
always welcome when it's come to you guys, so that's great.
So I'm looking forward to, I know we both have really an amazing set ready for everyone, and also how it looks and everything. It's going to be one, a 3 hour being blown away by just a great sets and stuff like that. So,
That's
and
awesome.
of course, also if a lot of people ask us, like, are Amy and you gonna sing something together, or Dan's gonna, play together on stage? We have decided that we're gonna have to let this exist spontaneously. So that's something that is the works the best, because if you already say I'm gonna, if you already tell each other before, somehow it doesn't really, I don't know, we like spontaneity, and so did they, so it's gonna be a
That's
spontaneous thing.
So if you go to the UK show, you might get a totally different experience with you and Amy and the bands on stage than someone in Germany might, but you might get all together. So every show is going to have some like a bit of spontaneity, like you just said. That's huge. That's awesome. I love that. It's been a while since I've actually heard of bands even trying like that. So good for you guys for trying to do something really good. You've had so many great collaborations with other artists and bands in the past, like just on the last album with Jacoby Shaddix, you've done stuff with Charja, Xzibit, things like that. My big question for you is, if there's one musician that you would love to collaborate with and never have before, who would it be? And it could be more than one, but like, is there someone that you would love to collaborate with that you just never got the chance to yet?
Well, not really. I mean, and some of them are dead, so that's not an option.
True.
But
Very true.
on the other hand, what we always do is we don't really look at who we would like to play or perform with, but more like, okay, we've written a song, and it could be a great duet. Who do we think it will who will fit on it? That's why we come to special guests, like an amazing guest like Xzibit, of course, which nobody had ever thought that we would ever, do a couple a featuring with. And so it's these things that we just look at the song, and I think that's the best way to do it. So what does the song need? Okay, we need this singer, and hopefully he will like the song and he will participate.
Yes. So it's more finding the right person for the role. So, okay. That I get that.
Yeah,
That
exactly.
makes sense. Awesome. So hopefully we get more surprises, like you said, from on the tours and things like that in future music. What are some of the things you have been able to do just to keep yourself sane during isolation where you are right now? Like, what are some of the things you've been trying to focus on while everything's on standstill?
Well, what I did, what I know, first of all, is something really simple to stay sane. For me, is something really simple and very basic, is actually stay in my own routine, daily routine.
Okay.
Same time going to bed, same time waking up, because otherwise, if every day it's already, if you go out of your rhythm, you really lose your mind. And of course, the rhythm itself is already difficult enough, because every day looks the same. You don't ever have weekends anymore because
It's very true. Yes, exactly.
it's boring as hell.
It is. I think there was like a research study said over 50% of the world population doesn't know what day it is anymore. They can't remember. And that's crazy to me.
I'm one of them. I'm one of them. Anyway,
Okay.
what I did for the fans helped me also. Is like I like to do workouts, but I was now, of course, really tied to home. Normally, I go to a personal trainer, and well, that wasn't happening. So I thought, like, okay, I'll do a workout at home, and I'll make a playlist that I love. So songs that are really high intensity, but I would like to have my favorite bands on it, but especially high intensity rock and metal kind of songs. So I made this on our streaming platforms. I made a workout list. It's called, of course, the Corona Quarantine Sweat It Out Workout,
That
but
is
it's really good
amazing.
actually.
Okay. I gotta know, can you give us like an example of some of the names on it though? Like some of your approved workout jam songs to help you get going.
Well, Bring Me the Horizon, a Shine
Okay.
Down. It could be, but it could be any band actually. But I have such a broad taste of music. Papa Roach is of course on it,
Okay.
but also oh God, now I can't get to the name. Punk band, punk bands. You're pretty fly for a white guy.
Offspring.
Offspring. So all these old and the golden songs, but also a lot of new stuff, but all high intensity songs, and yeah. And I really enjoy it. And even, some of my friends who are not really in heavier or up tempo kind of music, or my kind of music, I came across them. I was like, hey, if you want to have a workout, this is really good. And they started really enjoying it and getting into the music. It's like, oh, I've
Okay.
turned a few people into a different music direction.
Okay. Is this list on Spotify or on like?
Yeah, it is.
Okay, I'm gonna link that out in this video once I post it tomorrow,
Oh,
so that way
super.
people can
Yeah,
check it out
thanks.
too. I've never worked out to Pretty Fly for a White Guy. I'm gonna try it just to see how it works, because that sounds amazing.
It's pretty
It sounds like I'm
quick.
listening to the beat, just with a Give It to Me Baby. It's like, okay, this could work. So.
Wanted to have a little bit of craziness in the set
Yes,
list also.
exactly. You have to have some, you have to have fun while you're working out, and I think that song does
Exactly.
it. Yeah.
Yeah,
So,
totally.
okay, so you do have plans in 2020. We're going to be optimistic. Hopefully everything still happens on schedule. If you had a message to anyone watching right now, anything you want to say and end this with, what would it be?
No, I don't want to sound corny or anything, but the most important thing is that, I realize more and more every day how small the world actually is. And I think Walt Disney was really, really spot on when they said it's a small world after all. After all, it's like, when one thing happens in one country, it will affect another country eventually as well. I really believe that, if we do something to the environment or stuff, eventually it's just a small circle and will hit you on the other end, I'm just hoping that this is something you have to go through together. It's not every country for its own. So I really hope that, solidarity, unity, in this problem, I hope we'll all stand together, and hopefully there will be a virus attacker, a medicine, something that will take it away, and we can continue our normal lives more or less a little bit, and hopefully we will learn from it also, so in a way. But my message is, I just hope everybody will be safe, and I hope really to see everyone back again in America, hopefully next year.
Yes.
We'll see what happens, and I really hope everybody will be able to be there.